I'm a little bit opposite because I do mostly studio. I do everything, and it comes from a part of like not being lazy, but it's like to carry around.
That's lazy, bro.
No, but I'm saying like, okay, so I use palsy.
You got palsy buffs.
I got palsy buffs.
Is that why you have to go to?
Yes.
I guess we're gonna hit this topic.
Yeah, we're here. We're here right now.
So I got the Einsteins. You know what I mean? And
the Vagabonds.
They're so for portable for portability. They're kind of fragile. And also, you know, it's just, I don't know, man. Even with the modifiers that I have, it's pretty heavy stuff.
See, I had those lights, so I can tell. I can definitely tell you from experience. Like, I've had a, like I was telling you, there's a lot of trial and error that I had with my work. And I can break down the different years and what I've learned in those years. But the first thing I learned was, okay, palsy buff, no. That's what I learned slowly because I got them in 2011, the end of 2011. And it wasn't until, I believe, 2014 that I got another strobe.
Yeah.
So that was like a whole 3 years of saying, of like, okay, I'm gonna try these palsy buffs, see what I like, what I don't like, and then eventually I learned, okay, no, don't do.
Yeah. But no, you had the alien bees though, right?
Yeah, I had. Okay. I actually got too many lights. I started.
Oh damn.
I shoot with one light right now, and I shot with one light for years. But when I got the lights in 2011, I got four. I got two alien bee 800s.
Overkill.
Alien bee 400, and then I got the alien bee ring light 800. So I got those.
They have a ring light.
Yeah,
it's called the ABR 800.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, and I just overkill.
Well, yeah. Overkill. So the thing is, like, I feel like palsy buff lights. They have really, really good like color rendition. I love them, bro. I use them in my studio all the time. No complaints as far as in studio. You know what I mean? I even use the light mod gels modifier system, and it's just so easy to use. But yeah, just taking on location sometimes sucks. And then the Vagabond Mini, you got that, and then like I know like what's it called? The light stand that I have?
The light stand's heavy.
Weighs at least like 35 pounds, bro.
And if you don't have a...
What stand is that?
It's a... what's it called? Turtle...
C-stand?
Yeah. It's a black C-stand from B&H Photo.
Oh, yeah. I think I'm familiar with
it. I was going to say turtleneck. It's not turtleneck. turtle base, something like that. I don't know.
Yeah. I know what you're
Yeah, but I don't know, man. I like palsy buff, but I have been, like, for the past couple of years, just eyeballing the Godox. Just because of how one cheap they are, two like the AD200s.
There's the AD200s that look like speed lights. Yeah, they're small and powerful.
How bright are those?
So speed lights. Like I try to keep the power level in terms of watt seconds because that's kind of like the most broad term of describing all the different power levels of different lights. So speed lights typically have around 60 to 65 watts of power, and when it comes to the AD200s, they have 200 watts of power. Which is about three times as much as a single speed light,
right?
And it has kind of, and they're also this kind of the same size, of, a little bit bigger than a speed light,
yeah.
But it's three times as powerful, so they're powerful and small. So.